Listen to this. Listen to this, you fellows. You fellows, listen. General Grant chased the Rebs out of Richmond 4 days ago, and it's rumored that Lee's already surrendered.
The war is over.
Captain's papers. Get those Yanks out of here, quick. All right, you two, get this body out of here. Get him out of here, Davis. Party, get
come on, let's move.
Out of sight.
Come on. All right, come on, let's go.
Hurry it up, Mike. Hurry it up.
Cagle?
Yes, sir.
Brevet Major Harris.
We've been expecting you, Major. Here's the warrant for the payroll.
Well, you've brought a very small guard for this much money.
There's no Rebs in 50 miles of it, sir.
What about Randall's raiders?
We drove those bushwhackers clear out of Louisiana with their tails between their legs.
Well, all right, hand it down.
Well, where's the station agent?
He got taken sick all of a sudden. One of the boys took him back to camp.
Where are you going? Back to the train?
Go ahead. But just stand beside it with your mouth shut. And get on when it pulls out. I'll be watching you from this window.
Sign this receipt and get that money to your camp in a hurry.
Ain't that a beautiful sight? Makes you feel like a sore-eyed kitten with a whole basin full of milk.
Yeah, what a pity it don't belong to us.
How much you figure it comes to, Vance?
$12,250.
Lieutenant, how about making that a neat round sum? Say,
$10,000. And us fellas dividing up the difference.
Why, you thieving river rat, the army would shoot us for that.
Well, how'd they know about it? Who would tell?
I wouldn't, for one.
Me neither.
Look at us. A bunch of starved scarecrows. Whipped and dead broke. Ain't we got nothing coming out of this war except shriveled guts and saddle sores?
You got a mighty tempting argument. But I kind of doubt if it's legal.
It ain't legal, Vance. Or moral. Confederacy can use that money a heap more than we can.
You're right. Tomorrow we're taking this to General Randall.
Well, we tried anyway. Let's get into this grub.
The regiments broke camp and moved out.
Yeah, but where to? I don't know. The general said they'd wait for us right here.
Been away 8 days. Might have been attacked.
Or ordered away all of a sudden.
We better ride into Claysville and find out. What's your regiment, soldier?
5th Louisiana Rifles. Oh, what's left of them.
Where's Randall's outfit?
Well, all the cavalry disbanded 2 or 3 days ago. Scattered every which way so they wouldn't have to give up the horses.
You fellas would be wise to do likewise before the Yanks come and confiscate them.
Wait a minute, what are you talking about? What's happened?
What's happened? You mean you ain't heard?
General Lee surrendered to Grant 4 or 5 days ago. Appomattox Courthouse in Virginia.
Surrendered? You're crazy.
No, that's a fact, Lieutenant. All of us give up our guns in Shreveport last Monday.
So the war's over. We can all go home. If we got one left to go to.
Well, now that the brigade's split up and scattered, how are we going to find the general?
That's just it. We can't.
We've got to try, Badge.
Why?
Why? To give him the money, of course.
I don't know. The surrender changes everything. We got to talk it over.
Can't take this money, Vance. Don't rightly belong to us.
Then tell us who it does rightly belong to.
Well, it belongs to the Confederate government, I suppose.
Confederate government? There ain't no more Confederate government. It's finished.
That's the truth, Brett. They'll probably hang Jeff Davis and throw all the others in prison.
Well, and it must still be federal property.
You mean we ought to give it back to them? Like thunderation we will.
I got a mini ball in my leg that's got to be paid for.
Your own brother nearly died again being in a Yankee prison. Ain't that worth nothing to you?
Listen, Brett, we didn't steal this money. We took it in battle, fair and square. It's what they call spoils of war, like capturing a horse or anything else. We didn't know the war was over, and neither did the Federals. So it's still prize money.
And it's ours.
You don't have to take your share if it sticks in your craw.
How do you feel about this, Ray?
What Vance says makes sense to me. And if we really got a right to it, we'd be plumb fools not to take it.
So it's settled. I got it all figured out. We got $1,750 apiece coming to us.
Oh, we like it back to Georgia with this. I'm gonna buy me a hog and a dog and a rocking chair. And we all three just gonna sit there and scratch.
Not us. We're gonna fix us up the best farm in East Texas, huh, Vance?
You bet. But first, I'm gonna get married. Connie's been waiting 4 years. Seems more like 40 to me. And now, instead of going back to her empty-handed, I got this money.
Yanks!
Thank you.
gone sassy now if they licked us.
Not us, Mike. Maybe the South is licked, but... but not us. Still, it's smarter if we split up here and now. So long, Mike.
So long, guys.
Whenever you get to Texas, you know where to find us.
Vance, I ain't ever gonna leave that rocking chair. Goodbye, Fred. Lots of luck. Goodbye, Fred.
Here, aren't you? What happened to McComb?
He joined the army. I'm just minding the store till he gets back, if he's still alive.
Hey, Vance, how do you think Ma'd like this poke bonnet?
Oh, fine. That's pretty. Now, see if they have a fancy one with lace and long pink ribbons on it for Kathy.
No, that's the only one I got left. Anyhow, who feels free nowadays?
He does. He's going home to get married.
That's if we can clean him up enough so his sweetheart will recognize him.
Don't worry. Kathy will know me a mile away. Sure wish I could take a real nice present, like a gold ring or a bracelet or something.
Sorry, but that's all the female finery I got left, mister. Except this here bustle, which I've been using for a mousetrap.
And give us that, too.
Hey, Vance. Now, this is fit and proper for a bridegroom. Yep, and it's just your size, too.
Say, this feels like real broadcloth.
Sure is, mister. Probably the last good suit left in the state.
How much you want for it?
Well, with the pants, that'll cost you $14. And a throw in a pair of galluses is free.
I'll take it.
I mean hard money. None of them Confederate shin plasters.
This look hard enough for you?
A $20 federal bill. I ain't even seen one of these in 63.
Does that cover what we owe you?
Sure, sure. I'll go wrap them up.
Well, Jethro. Well, I'll be dad burned if it ain't old Jethro.
Hey, Jethro! You're a sight for sore eyes.
Hey, you worthless old rascal. How'd you ever stay alive all these years?
What's the matter, Jethro? We ain't changed that much, have we?
You look kind of surprised to see us.
Why, we all heard you were dead, Mr. Vance.
Well, it done there was.
That mini-ball just misspelt my name a little. See ya. You mean our folks don't even know I'm alive?
No, sir. Nobody does.
Come on, we'll ride by Kathy's house and tell her first.
She ain't there no more, Mr. Vance. Her folks was killed in the same raid your pa was.
Where is she?
Over at your place. She moved in with your ma.
Out, we go off and fight 4 years, but they come and kill him right here at home.
Whole place looks mighty run down.
Yeah, plumb wore out like us.
Come on, let's go in yelling like we used to.
Come on.
But here's what's left of me, Ma.
Just think. All three of you. Fred. Fred. Oh, my son.
Kathy!
Let me have a good look at you, honey. Here. That's just how I've seen you night and day for 4 long years. Except for those bridges.
Clint! Clint! See ya. Vance!
Oh, no. No, this can't be the Sprat. Look at how he's grown and filled out. Why, he's almost a man now, ain't he, Kathy?
I told us you were dead.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. I know. Now, come on. Tell me about y'all. I can see we got a heap of work to do around here. And the first thing is to get Kathy out of those britches and into a dress.
I've been trying to, but she works hard on a mule all day helping me and Ma.
Well, you don't have to anymore, honey. We got 3 new farmhands. Come on. I got a bushel of things to tell you.
Vance, I don't reckon you could have known about this, but me and Kathy got married about 3 months ago.
Married? Well, this is a day of surprises all around.
I don't know what we'd have done without Kathy, son, or her without us after her folks died. We had mighty poor scratching to keep body and soul together, waiting for the war to end.
Yeah, it must have been hard. Well, congratulations, Clint. We always did want Kathy in the family. Didn't we, Ma?
Yes, son. Always.
Hey, Kathy. Look at the nicks on this saber Vance just gave me. Hey, how many Yankees did y'all get all in all, between the 3 of you?
No, we didn't stop to count them, Clint.
Whole bunch of them, huh?
Most of those nicks came from butchering pigs, Clint.
Yeah, I'll bet. The blue ones with the brass buttons. Boy, I wish I'd have been there with you. I'll bet y'all got my share.
It's all I could do to keep him home. He just ran and raved every time we got news of a battle.
You did right to stay here, Clint. You did fine.
I love my bonnet. You boys shouldn't have spent what little you got on me.
Well, that's a mighty poor gift, Ma, for all you've given us.
Hey, looky here. A brand new Sunday go-to-meeting suit.
Well, that's a present for you, Clint, from all of us.
For me? Gee, it must have cost a fortune. Where'd you get all the money?
Oh, we had some saved up. And we still got a few dollars left, Mom.
Well, that's more than we got, son. Sit down while everything's hot. Come on, Ted. You're hungry, aren't you? Dear Lord, I thank you most kindly for bringing my boys back home all safe and sound.
Well, there's a leak in this old building. Yes, there's a leak in this old building. Well, there's a leak in this old building. We're gonna move to a better home. We got no pain. This old wind,
we got no pain.
We got no pain. In this old wind,
we got no pain.
We got no pain.
We got no pain.
In this old wind,
we got no pain.
We're gonna move to a better home. Well, there's a hole in the roof where the rain pours in. A hole in the floor where it runs right out again. Well, there's a leak.
There's
this old building.
Well, there's a leak.
Well, there's a leak.
Yes, there's a leak.
In this old building.
There's a leak.
Well, there's a leak.
There's a leak.
In this old building.
Let her leak.
We're gonna move to a better home. Well, there's a crack across the ceiling. Yes, there's a crack across the ceiling. Well, there's a crack across the ceiling. We're gonna find us a better home. Well, we got a stove.
We got a stove.
Without a chimney.
We got a stove.
We got a stove. Without a chimney.
We got a stove.
What good's a stove?
We got a stove.
Without a chimney.
We got a stove.
We're gonna move to a better home. Pulling down window shades is no use at all. The kids and the neighbors can't peek right through the wall. Well, there's a leak.
There's a leak.
In this old building.
Well, there's a leak.
Well,
there's a leak. Yes, there's a leak.
In this old building.
There's a leak.
Well, there's a leak.
There's a leak.
In this old building.
Look out below.
We're gonna move to a better. Move to a better. Move to a better.
It's sure good to hear him sing again, hey, Vance?
It sure is. All we're missing now is Pa.
Yeah. Remember how we all used to set out here at night and sing, Ma?
Indeed I do, son. Brings back a heap of good memories.
Vance used to sing the loudest. This song was his favorite.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true. All my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me long. Take me to your heart. For it's there that I belong and will never part. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, and I always will. Love me tender, love me dear, tell me you are mine. I'll be yours through all the years, till the end of time. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always.
I get to work before sun up. We better turn in.
Yeah, a lot of things around here need fixing.
What's troubling you, Vance? You ain't your old self tonight.
Oh, I'm all right. A little tired, I reckon.
Vance, I know you and Kathy used to be kind of fond of each other, but Well, you ain't got no hard feelings against either one of us now, have you?
Hard feelings? Me? Why, of course not.
You really mean that, down deep?
Listen, Clint, did I ever lie to you?
No.
All right. Oh, I liked Kathy, sure, but we all did. But, I was never in love with her. We were just real good friends. And that's how it still is. So don't you ever think nothing else. Why? I'm just happy for both of you.
I hoped it'd be that way, Vance. We're so much in love, I can never tell you.
Why, you don't have to, Clint. It's written all over your face. And hers, too.
You go on to bed. I'm gonna lock the barn because there's still a lot of stragglers on the road. They might try to steal our horses.
Yeah? You can't even trust a Reb nowadays. I'll see you in the morning, Clint.
God, let me talk to you. You never said one word to me tonight. Please let me try and explain.
There's nothing to explain.
Oh, but there is. Please let me... Give me a chance to tell you.
Coming to bed, Vance? How soon do you figure we can tell the folks about the money?
Well, maybe 2 or 3 months. We'll spend a little bit of time so as not to start talk.
You're the boss, Vance. Whatever you think's best. We gotta buy seed and a new hire if we hope to get a good crop this summer.
The crop will have to wait. The money we got hidden in here is a lot better than seed. Worked her shoe loose. It's all right now.
Please, Vance. I've been trying to see alone for more than a week now. Won't she even try and understand?
Nobody asks why a woman falls in love and gets married.
You do. You ask me with every look, and you've got no right to think I was faithless. I waited for you, just like I promised. I thought about you all day long and prayed for you every night. And that letter came saying you were dead. I didn't want to live myself anymore. I loved you, Vance. With all my heart and soul, I loved you dearly. You know I did. How can you doubt it?
That's what hurts the most, Kathy. I know. And I can't forget it.
Well, we got to, both of us. We can't go on living here under the same roof.
I know that, too. Maybe time will take care of it. I want you to be happy.
I never will be unless you are, Vance. I can hear you lying awake at night, and I know what you're thinking about. me and Clint side by side? Why'd you tell him there was never anything between us?
Well, do you want me to tell him the truth?
He already knows it. I told him myself before we were married.
Why?
Because I don't like living with a lie. He believed you when you said you never loved me. He'll believe anything you tell him because he loves you just as much as he loves me. So if he's big enough to forget what's past, then you can too. Oh, please, Vance, please try for my sake. Dream, I guess, the war and everything.
Oh, don't cry. We're all safe again. There's nothing to worry about anymore.
I hope not. To lose you again so soon. I knew this was going to happen, son. I could see the heartbreak growing in you. I reckon what you're doing is right.
There's no other way, Ma. I've tried to hide it, but I can't stay on. Sooner or later, Clint would see.
He might guess now anyway.
No, he won't. I tell him I'm going out to California just for a few months to look around. He'll believe it. And the rest of you will never tell him.
When you planning to go?
Tomorrow. No, Ma. The quicker, the better. Tomorrow we'll all be going out to the raising of the new schoolhouse. I'll tell Clint and Kathy there and leave before they can try and stop me.
They'll both be mighty upset, Vance.
Maybe so. But they won't make a scene in front of all our friends.
I wouldn't be too sure of that. Clint thinks the sun rises and sets in you.
I know, Ma. That's just why I'm going.
Hey, you girls look pretty today. I'm gonna have to keep an eye on both of you.
Go on, Clint.
Hey, Ray. Tell the fellas to hurry it up. We don't want to miss any of the fun.
Right.
90, 95, 2. How come you're only taking 200, Vance?
You all need it more than I do. Give Ma the rest of my share when you figure it's safe. Tell her the truth how we got it and that it's rightfully ours.
Seems fair, you giving up everything this way.
Yeah, Vance, come on. Take more than $200. Yeah. You got a long way to go. You got to have a stake out west.
I'll get a job somewhere. Don't worry about me. Now, come on. Act natural. I don't want Clint and Kathy to suspect anything.
Come on, fellas. What kept you so long?
Greasing your hair for all them girls to picnic? Hey, folks, come this way, right this way. Take a chance, spend the money to build a school. Hey, hey, you missed. One more. Hey, you missed again. Right this way, folks. Come on, get the money up to build a school. Everybody, come on this way.
Well,
right this
way. $20 bills. We want the money to build that schoolhouse over there.
Whenever I dance with a girl I love, my head goes round and round. When she is close to me, I can't stay on the ground. Whenever I dance with a girl I love, I never have a care. All night I'm so light, I walk right on the air.
Oh, let me, honey,
let me do what you know I love to do. Please take another chance and let me have another dance with you. Whenever I feel those pretty arms reaching around about, that feeling goes through my toes and all the lights go out, go out. Whenever I see those eyes of blue smiling up so shy, I'm in such a spin, I take a ride off and fly. So let me, honey, let me do what you know I love to do. Please take another chance and let me have another dance with you. So let me dance in the arms I love, thrilling through and through. I'm so drunk with love and all I see is you. I never hear the music play, I never see the crowd. Only you and me dancing on a cloud. Oh, let me, honey, let me. Let me do what you know I love to do. Please take another chance and let me have another dance with you.
I know she's not a day over 20 years old. She'll last.
They call me poor boy, poor boy, poor boy, but I ain't lonesome and I ain't blue, 'cause I could never be a poor boy as long as I've got a darling like you. Ain't got a crust, ain't got a cent, can't buy a jug, can't pay the rent. I got a heart full of dreams and a lot of memories, and that's enough for me. They call me poor boy, poor boy, poor boy, but I ain't lonesome and I ain't blue, 'cause I could never be a poor boy as long as I got a darling like you. Can't buy a house, can't buy a lot, ain't got a bean, ain't got a pot, but what I got is a heart full of love and memory, and that's enough for me. They call me poor boy, poor boy, poor boy, but I ain't lonesome and I ain't blue, 'cause I could never be a poor boy as long as I got a darling like you. Don't have a pig, don't have a cow, I don't have a horse to pull a plow, but what I got is a heart full of love and memory, and that's enough for me. They call me poor boy, poor boy.
What do you mean going away? Where?
Well, I've got an old army friend who's got a ranch out in California. He's with me. He needs a partner, and I've been getting kind of restless anyway.
That's not your reason, Vance. You're leaving because of me and Clint.
Maybe so. I can't meet his eyes after what you told me.
We don't want you to go, Vance. This is your home. We all love you.
A home can be full of too much love, Kathy. Then one night it burns up, and everybody in it.
I can't stay on here facing the others, knowing you left because of me, and they knowing it, too.
I guess you'll have to learn.
Oh, Vance, you can't go. You know how I feel.
Don't say it, Kathy.
You know that.
Even if it's true, don't say it. Not now. Not ever.
Kathy, what's the matter? What's wrong? What's wrong with Kathy?
I told her I was going away, Clint. And I was coming to tell you.
Away? What do you mean?
Lance! Ray! Brett! These fellows want to talk to you. Vance, that's Major Kincaid. And this gentleman's Mr. Siringo.
Howdy. Won't you light and join us?
No, thank you. Our business won't take long.
We hope.
I've been engaged by the federal government to recover property that was lost or stolen during the war.
Well, that's good news. We lost a lot of things around here. You want our list?
No, we've got our own. Three of you Reno brothers were members of Randall's Cavalry Brigade, a unit of which attacked the railroad station at Greenwood, Louisiana, on the morning of April 10th, 1865, 8 weeks ago. By impersonating federal soldiers, you took a U.S. Army payroll amounting to $12,250 from an officer who was on the train. Now, those may have been your orders from General Randall, but apparently none of you knew that the war was already over. And had been since noon of the preceding day.
Got any idea what he's talking about?
No, I don't.
He's got us mixed up with some other fellas.
There's no mistake. We found one of the men who got away with you, and we recovered his share of the money. What's more, he told us who stole the rest.
Then he's lying.
Don't be foolish, Vance. I've known all you boys since you was knee high, and I'd sure hate to see you get in any trouble. So if you got the money, go on. Give it back now.
We didn't steal any money, Ed.
Well, that's possible, but we mean to make sure. The federal paymaster can identify the men who took the money from him.
So we're going to take you to him.
You got anyone who wants to see us, you bring him here. We're not leaving.
We hoped you'd make no trouble. But if this is how it is, you're all three under arrest. We're taking you into Tyler in tonight's train. Now get your horses.
You ain't got no right to do this. My brother's never lied or stole nothing from nobody.
Stay out of this, Clint. Go on. Get the horses.
Vance.
Now, don't worry, Ma. Everything's gonna be all right. Don't you worry.
Don't worry, Martha. I'll go with him.
If that paymaster recognizes you, we're done for.
How can he? We were all bearded then. He can't tell us now from Adam.
What happened, Mr. Vance? You boys in some kind of trouble?
Nothing serious, Jethro. Just a little misunderstanding. We'll get it cleared up right shortly.
I'll tell you, the whole thing's a pure frame-up.
Clint, there must be something behind all this.
Sure there is.
Go on, get me some hot water.
The Federals are taking revenge against Randall's men for driving them crazy all during the war. Start making up some lying charges like stealing money or something.
What'll they do with Vance?
Oh, they'll probably clap him in some stinking prison somewhere.
What's the matter, Clint?
Well, what did you say, just Vance? We were worried about all three of them, weren't we?
Well, of course we are. That's what I meant.
What was that?
Somebody just rolled up.
There. No, now, put that gun down.
You stay in here.
Who are you? What do you want here?
Is your name Reno?
Yeah, what about it?
We're friends of your brother's. Is there any of them around? Vance, Brett, or Ray?
No, what?
We come to warn him. There's some federal men out looking for him.
You're too late. They arrested all three of them this morning on some lying charge and took them away. It was a lie, wasn't it?
Sure it was.
Where'd they take your brothers?
To town. Tonight they're going on a train to Tyler to stand trial.
Let's get going.
Wait, wait! I'm going with you.
We gotta stop him before something terrible happens.
Who are you men? How do we know your friends are Vance?
Don't worry, miss. We know you well enough. You're Kathy. Vance must have showed us your picture 1,000 times. Ain't it natural that his brother wants to help us get him free? Good night, miss.
I understand how you might feel about this money. Even if they don't identify you, it can still send you to prison. The three of you. I don't want to send you boys to prison. All I want is to recover the money. I'll make you a fair proposition. You tell me you'll give me the money back, and I give you my word we'll drop the charges. Forget the whole thing. This is your last chance. If they identify you tomorrow, you'll get 10 years. Even if they should let you go, you'll be watched for the rest of your life. The money do you no good. I know you've got it. Here's the $20 bill you spent at that Crossroads store. You know, it's funny. If the war had gone the other way, you might have been questioning him instead of me.
What do you say?
We haven't got all of it, only our shares.
Where's the rest?
I don't know.
It's no good. We want it all.
I'm willing to do what you say, but we can't give you more than we've got.
We've got no deal.
Sit still, mister, don't make any moves.
Sal, you get shot.
Get his gun, Ray.
Get his gun and keys and unlock those cuffs.
Stop the crane at that water tower. Come on, grab the brake. Nobody will get hurt.
What the devil are you doing here?
You didn't think I'd let you down, did you?
Get Martin, get out of here.
How?
They got away.
We've got to get back to Bedford just as fast as possible. Conductor, I want you to telegraph descriptions of these six men to the surrounding counties of Saline, Tyler, and Crockett. Leave orders to shoot on sight. They're armed.
Yes, sir.
Engineer, get up there and back this train into Bedford fast.
Yes, sir.
I can't believe the Reno boys planned this getaway. You saw their faces. They were surprised as we were.
You can believe what you like, Marshal. I say they knew. Why, they had everything timed to the split second. Don't you agree, Mr. Sringle?
Well, it certainly looks that way, Major, but I'm not sure I can agree with you. If the escape was planned, why would Vance confess to me?
That's what I mean. He was ready to...
What are you two trying to do, defend this man? Look, you had your chance and you failed. Now I'm going to get him my way. And the money...
All right, Clint. Get on back home where you belong.
Why?
You heard me get going before somebody sees you with us.
Well, that's a lot of thanks for helping you escape.
I didn't want your help. None of you.
You was being took to prison, wasn't you?
I could have made a deal with Siringo. Now he'll be gunning for us.
But we got a head start on him. We could be halfway to the Mississippi before morning. Hop a boat downriver and he'll never catch us.
Hold on. We're going to get off the road and settle this here and now. Ed, Party, Mike, I led you fellas through 4 years of fighting, and I never once steered you wrong, did I? So you ought to know by now that nobody hates giving up more than I do. But these federal men will hound us until we're all dead or behind bars.
So you did take the payroll. Why don't you tell me the truth?
We felt we had a right to it, Clint. It spoils a war.
We did have a right to it. You told us that yourself. What changed your mind?
Siringo, in common sense, he offered to forget the whole thing if we surrendered the money. And I got a hunch he'll still do it, in spite of that train holdup. Nobody was hurt. Nobody was robbed.
I vote we give it back, Vance. A few $1,000 ain't worth that risk.
I agree. We've been shot at enough for one lifetime.
What about you?
You two boys can do as you please. I'm keeping my share.
Me, too. And me.
You'll never get away with it. They'll organize a manhunt and scour the country. And now they know you, they'll shoot you in sight.
We'll take our chances.
Mike, don't be stupid. There's nothing in this for you now but trouble.
And the trouble with you is that you've lost your guts. Come on, boys, let's get out of here.
Hold it! This deal with Siringa was only good if we turn in all the money. So if I gotta save your necks, too, that's the way it is. Get it. And their guns. Now, I'm going back to get our shares. And I'll meet you right after daybreak at Hannah's Mill. Brett, that means you and Ray, too.
How do we know you ain't lying? Maybe this here Siringo didn't make you any deal at all.
Yeah, and even if he did, how good is his word?
I'd trust it. Clint, nobody knows you're in on this. So you ride into town and tell Siringo I'll come in with the money, all of it, tomorrow morning. And you come to the mill and give us his answer. That satisfy you?
What choice have we got?
Go on, Clint. Get going.
And we thought he was our friend.
He is, Mike. Best one you ever had.
We found nothing so far. If the money's still here, they must have buried it somewhere.
Martha, if you know where it is or where the boys are, you better tell us before it's too late.
But I don't know. They had no money, and we haven't seen any of them since you took them off yesterday.
Well, it's the truth. Why can't you believe us? We don't know any more than what you've told us.
Where's Clint?
He went into town.
I'm sorry to have to do this, ma'am. But we're leaving three men here, day and night.
What for?
Just in case your sons come back, for any reason.
Martha?
Jethro. Where'd you come from?
Don't ask questions, Jethro. Just listen. We're in bad trouble, but it may work out if you'll help us.
Well, you know I will, Mr. Vance.
If they do come back tonight, these men will shoot them. We can't just stay here and do nothing to stop them.
Well, how can we warn them? We've got no idea where they are.
I'm going to ride into town. There must be someone there who can help them.
Maybe they won't let you go.
I can try.
Jethro, what are you doing here? Where'd you get that?
Mr. Vance sent me for it, Miss Kathy.
Where is he?
Up in my cabin.
Well, give it to me.
But he said I should
bring it to... Because the soldier outside, and if they catch you, get down.
Need any help, ma'am?
No, thank you.
Well, let me throw the saddle on anyhow. It's too heavy for a girl like you.
I can manage. I do it myself every day.
One of these Reno brothers is your man.
That's none of your business.
No need to be testy, ma'am. I'm just trying to be friendly. The war's over, or ain't you heard?
Don't seem like it. Ransacking our house, tearing the barn apart. Anyway, you can't leave decent folks alone.
Decent folks don't go around stealing money or holding up trains, do they? We got orders, ma'am. Nobody's to leave here without being searched first.
Well, go ahead, search me.
Well, if anybody asks, you tell them I searched. I don't want to get in no trouble.
Kathy, what are you doing here?
I brought the money. Where are the others?
They're waiting for me. We're going to give it back. Then they'll let us go free, we hope.
Well, they don't know that. They got orders to shoot you on sight.
Then I've got to get to Siringo first. Clint rode into town to tell him I was coming. So give me the money and we'll...
Wait. Don't move.
If we can get across that swamp, there's a place beyond where you can hide. You willing to try?
And after you've given the money back, will you still go away?
Yeah.
Won't help, Vance. We won't ever forget each other.
You and I know that, Kathy. But nobody else must ever know.
You see Siringo?
Yeah.
What do you have to say?
He agreed. He said to bring the money into town before dark and he'd drop charges.
What about us?
All of you. But he says you got to take a chance riding in because Major Kincaid don't trust you. And you can't get word to him. Where's Vance? He should have been here by now.
That's what we figured.
I ran into old Jethro down the road. He said Vance came to his place a little after daylight. Kincaid's men were watching our place, so he sent Jethro in to fetch the money. And Kathy took it from him and rode out to meet Vance.
Is that the girl we saw back in the farm?
That's right. She's my wife.
Your wife?
She was Vance's girl.
Go ahead, Clint. What else old Jethro have to say?
The soldiers jumped him and they had to make a run for it. That's all he knows.
Didn't Kathy come back home?
No.
Probably rode a long way by this time.
Yeah, in any direction. What do you mean by that?
He's got all the money now, ain't he?
What are you trying to say? Advance to double-cross us?
Not only us. Didn't you know he was crazy about your wife?
You're wrong, Mike. Yes, he liked Kathy once, but that ended years
ago. What are you lying to him for? We know better.
He carried her picture all through the war.
Said he was going to marry her as soon as he got home.
It's about time somebody opened your eyes, kid. He wanted her, and now he's run away with her.
And with our money.
They probably had it all figured out.
Clint! Clint, wait a minute! Come on, Ray. We got to find them before he does.
They could all be in on this. Come on.
Nobody knows about this place except Brett and Ray. We used it on hunting trips when we were boys.
Now, you'll be safe here while I'm gone.
Oh, it's you I'm worried about, Vance. You got no way of knowing what Siringo told Clint. If it's no, they'll kill you.
That's a chance I got to take. Clint will be waiting for me at the mill.
What'll you do if he isn't?
Go into town, give him back the money. So you stay here. And I'll send somebody for you by nightfall.
What makes you so sure they're headed west? You ain't in cahoots on this by any chance, trying to throw us off the trail.
Why not? Then you brothers lose us and join them somewheres. That could be the plan.
You fool, you think I'd send my own wife out to risk getting shot?
Yeah, maybe not. All this about her and Vance to put on, you still got us to settle with.
Huh. There ain't nothing put on with them two, I'll bet you. My guess is they put one over on all of us.
Shut up! I don't want to hear no more.
Then find him, and fast.
Don't worry, I got more reason than you have.
If he finds him, he won't even wait to listen. He's half crazy now.
Vance wouldn't run out on us. He's probably hiding out till we... Hey, hold on. I know where he might be. Let him ride on.
Right, that's Kathy's mare.
Then he went to the mill to meet you and the others, taking the money with him. When he doesn't find you there, he'll go on to town to face Siringo alone.
Yeah, we figured that's how it was. Look, Kathy, something's come up you gotta know about.
Flynn thinks you run off with Vance.
Well, I did. I told you.
No, I don't mean like that. He thinks you left him for good.
Well, that's not true. Whoever put that idea in his head?
Gavin's bunch. They think Vance took the money and you to clear out.
Let me try to reason with him, but he wouldn't listen to me. He's out of his mind with jealousy.
If he finds Vance now, there's no telling what he'll do.
Well, let me talk to him. Where is he?
Come on, we'll try and find him.
What more proof do we want? Now your brothers have cut loose and joined us.
I told you they was all in this together, Mike. This one's just leading us on.
You'll see if I am. All I want to do is find him if it takes the rest of my life.
Listen to her, Clint. Listen careful.
Clint, you don't believe all these things a man told you, do you?
Nobody had to tell me. I reckon I've always known it. This just plain showed me.
Clint, let me tell you.
Quit lying to me, Kathy. I've heard all your lies and believed them just like you wanted me to. Like the night you stood at our window crying, saying it was only a bad dream. And then yesterday at the schoolhouse when you ran away from me because of something you advanced and said.
No, Clint, listen, I'm not...
Stop it, Clint! Give her a chance! For what, to deny it? She can't. Go on, say it, Kathy. Say I'm lying. Say you want your lover. Say you ain't laid awake every night by my side thinking of him. Wishing I was Vance. Wishing you'd waited for him and never married me.
Shut up, Clint. There ain't none of it so.
Tell me he's never had you in his arms since you came back. Tell me he hasn't kissed
you. Stop it, Clint. You're hurting.
You can't say it because it's true. What a creep. You love him, don't you?
No, stop it.
You're lying. You love him. What a creep. You know you do. You lied to him. What a creep.
Stop it. You're crazy. You're a mad dog.
You would have killed her. What are you trying to do? You know what you meant to each other, what does that do? You're just trying to protect yourself! Get. Hold it, Ray. Come on. You're going home. I want you to go back where we found you. I want you to wait for Vance in case he returns. Warn him what happened. Tell him to stay there till we come. Now get out of here. Go on. I sent her home. Now you're going into town with us. Now get mounted.
Hold it, Brett. You're lying to you, Clint, about her going home. She's heading back to him wherever he's hiding out. All we got to do is follow her.
That's a lie. Vance is on his way to Hannah's mill to try and find us. With the money to meet Siringo, like he promised.
You think we're going to swallow that?
Artie, get their guns. Give Clint back his gun. Now, Clint, you can do what you want. We're trailing her.
You're right. They're still trying to throw us off.
Now, you two can go back to the mill. Or to Hades, as far as we're concerned. But don't follow us. Let's go, boys.
Gotta find Vance, but where? We'll try the mill first. If he's not there, we'll try to catch him before he gets to town.
What'd I tell you? She led us straight to him.
Where is he?
Clint, I don't know.
You're lying. Where is he?
Brett told you the truth.
You're just trying to protect him. Where is he?
Leave her alone, Clint. That ain't helping us none. He wouldn't have left her here unless he was coming back.
So we'll just sit here until he walks in.
Now they're gunning for you, Vance. Clint with them. They all think you double-crossed them.
Maybe the three of us can jump them and knock some sense into their heads before anybody gets hurt.
First, we got to get rid of this. Ray, you take it and ride into town fast. Give it to Siringo and tell him what's happened.
Where are you going?
Well, we'll try and get back to the cave ahead of him and wait. You bring what help you can. Now get going.
Vance? Never give you a chance to explain now. We tried, so did Kathy. Clint came near to killing her for it.
He'll listen to me.
I'm warning you, he's more dangerous than any of them.
That's him, with Brett.
All right, get out of sight. Watch her. We'll wait till they get up close.
They're ahead of us.
Yeah. They're up there with her.
Must have seen us coming.
You stay here. This is my job.
Wait a minute, Vance. Any one of them's liable to shoot you.
Not Clint. He couldn't. And he'd stop the man who tried.
You haven't seen his face.
Clint!
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 Can you hear me, Clint? I know what you're thinking, Clint. But you got it all wrong. Dead wrong. Oh, Kathy, dead was to bring me the money. There's nothing else between us, I swear it. Nothing at all.
But I know different, don't I?
I was going away, Clint. And I'm still going for good. But I had to square things with Siringo first, and I've done it.
He couldn't have. He ain't had time to get to town and back. It's a scheme. He's trying to draw us out.
Listen to me, Clint. Ray's gone in to take Siringo the money. That'll give us clean hands, all of it. Unless one of you loses his head now and adds killing to it.
He's lying to you about the money. He's still got it on him. He only came back for her. And she knows it.
Why don't you answer me, Clint?
What's stopping you? Can't you see you're just stalling? Working closer till he can jump us. Probably got Ray and Brett working around behind us.
What's troubling you?
Well, go on. You asked for him. Take him.
I got no reason to lie to you. I only came to tell you our trouble's over. We can go home with nothing to fear.
Go home.
Go home to what?
Well, go on. Take him now, or I'll take him myself.
Get out of here. Get away from him. Leave him alone.
Hey, look out. can't. Where's Vance? I gotta talk to him.
Right here, Clint.
Vance, I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it.
I know you didn't, Clint. You don't have to tell me. Everything's gonna be all right.
Love me tender.